Hello everyone. Today's video is about this knife. It's a knife made by me. It's a spring steel, about 57 Rockwells, and industrial micarta handle. It's a brown color. I like the color very much. The pins are from stainless steel and also the linear tube. The blade, it's a full flat grind in zero, wide enough for a good slicer, and I hope also for a good battener. This knife, I made it as a companion knife. I observed that usually I used my saw more than my knife in the woods, so it was worthless to carry a heavy and big blade knife instead of a smaller one and pair with my saw. I cut much faster the wood with the saw than with a chopping knife. And today I want to try it. I want to make the fire, but for a shorter video I already prepared some wood here. I just saved that 2 pieces of wood for battening, and I have there a smaller piece which I will feather, and then I will start the fire in the rest, and I want to prepare lunch. It's not quite lunchtime, but I didn't eat it yet, so let's see. First I will baton. I will have a special care because I broke one knife, my favorite knife, in the past with something like that. So let's see. First, the batoning test. So about 9 centimeters in diameter, hazelnut tree, yes. As you've seen, I hope. So Nothing special happened to the blade, but I was careful. And the pieces I saved was straight grain, but usually hazelnut grows like a straight grain, so it's nothing special. Now I have also a tiny piece of hazelnut tree, tiny branch there, I already broke it there, yeah. And I want to feather few feathers, not too much. These are the feathers. It's not the best feather I have, but this is mainly because of the full flat and zero grind. Usually with thicker blades and convex or Scandi, we can do a better job with the feather stick. With the feather stick. Now I will start the fire. Let's see, I will use my lighter and a cotton ball with Vaseline. While the fire is gaining some power, I will cut the sausage I bought for today. I have a very bushcraft cutting board. And the sausage. Something spicy, of course. I don't know how spicy, but spicy. I think just one is enough. Okay, like so. Now I wait for some coals and then I will cook them over the coals. I will make the pause on the video because it'll be too long. Okay, the fire is much lower now. I find the way to keep the sausages on the fire. I want to make a higher stand for the sausage, so I will cut this piece of willow. Just a little higher. Okay, now it's time. For a conclusion. The knife. It's a bushcraft knife? No, I don't find it very, very useful in bushcraft tasks. So it will do some of bushcraft tasks, like battening or feather, but not in a way a dedicated bushcraft knife will do. It's a hunter? I don't know. I talked with a friend, which is a hunter, and he told me the blade is too long for a hunting knife. And the handle said that it's very comfortable also for his hand. Sorry, I am hungry. Is this a survival knife? I don't know. In my opinion, it's too thin for a survival knife, but that depends also how you know what to do with your knife in a survival situation. No, I don't think for myself it's a survival knife. I have one in construction, but this one is not a survival knife. But as we've seen, we can do a little bit of everything. That's why I think this knife, I concept this knife like a companion one. Instead, it's a very good slicer, so it slices very, very well. I think even if it would be dull, I could slice things because so thin apex. Okay, so this was my today project. I like the knife. Of course I like it because I made it. I start this project as a gift for someone, but I don't think this knife will end as a gift. Maybe for me, who knows. Anyway, I have two blades on the same design. This one is finished, the other one is not finished yet, but the characteristics are the same. We'll see. Okay, thank you, and I wish you all a good day.